Hey everyone, name's Lohit. You are watching my channel LG The Curious. Let's get started. So this video will be kind of a detailed overview on earphones. So if you don't have time to watch such a long video, then you can switch over to my previous video. But if you want to know more about earphones, then stay with me as I proceed further. So earphones were popularized after the introduction of the Walkman portable tape player in the 1970s. Before that, earphones had their use particularly in the medical industry as hearing aids. So before we proceed further, make sure you click that subscribe button and click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any of my latest videos. So actually these were the ones that were initially introduced along with the portable music players. These earphones have such a design that made it clear that these weren't made to insert into the ear canal rather than they fit into the outer part of the ear. So due to the absence of the foam padding, using it for longer hours made the experience uncomfortable, and the design made it pretty clear that you can't block most of the environmental noise with it. Later on, these were introduced. These have been actually categorized into in-ear headphones because they have this silicone padding and they insert into the ear canal, which means that first of all, they are comfortable for using it for longer periods, and if you are inserting it into the ear canal, they kind of seal out the inner ear. So they block out most of the environmental noise. So the term AirPods were not popularized until 2001 when Apple introduced their portable MP3 music player. Now let's take a look at some of the technical specifications of earphones. The specifications of earphones are pretty much the same as headphones. The only difference is that the driver size of earphones is smaller as compared to headphones, because of which they compromise on the sound quality. But it provides an advantage of portability of earphones over headphones. So before we move on to the technical specifications of earphones, I wanted to discuss about a term, that is noise reduction. Basically, there are two terms that headphone or earphone manufacturers use. There is passive noise isolation and there is active noise reduction. So passive noise isolation is what the in-ear headphones provide. They kind of seal the inner ear, because of which it blocks out most of the environmental noise. Pairing that with active noise cancellation, they actually use the microphones to cancel out the external environmental noise, and the output usually results in a cleaner sound. But that mostly works in areas where there is a stable and a constant frequency, like in the case of airports or in the railway stations, or in case of traffic where the frequency is constant. But if there is a large variation in frequency, the result is not that good. Now let's take a look at the technical specifications of earphones. The specifications of earphones are pretty much the same compared to headphones. The only difference is that the driver size is much smaller compared to headphones, because of which they compromise on the sound quality. But the advantage they provide is portability. You can carry them anywhere you want, but that's not the case with headphones. But if you want to know more about all the specifications, you can check out my previous video. Now let's move over to the risks associated with using earphones. The first one that is pretty obvious is regarding the temporary or permanent hearing loss. If you are using your earphones for a longer period of time and at higher volumes, there are chances that you may face temporary or permanent hearing loss over the period of time. The risk is actually more in the case of earphones, because they actually don't block out most of the external noise. That's why people tend to crank up the volume, and that increases the risk. The second risk associated is regarding the earwax. If you are using your earphones and are sharing it with someone else, the person along with you are prone to ear infection, because you're actually inserting the earphones inside your ear, due to which the earwax accumulates over this silicone tip. That's why if you're sharing it with someone else, chances are this earwax may get inserted inside the ear canal of the other person, which makes him or her prone to ear infection. So my advice will be to use your audio device as a personal device and don't share it with anyone else. A story began circulating on March this year that scientists signed a declaration warning about danger to human health posed by AirPods and wireless headphones. This was totally incorrect. The scientific declaration referenced actually on the potential health threats due to the non-ionizing frequency due to cell phones and wireless devices. After years of research, the US scientists found out that the non-ionizing frequencies caused cancer and brain tumors in rats. Till that point, the federal government and the cell phone manufacturers assumed that non-ionizing frequencies had no potential harmful effect. So now it's all up to the scientific community to figure out if the non-ionizing frequency is harmful for humans. If yes, then up to what doses and how much the case of the rats are relatable to humans. But if you are skeptical about the AirPods or Bluetooth headsets, my advice will be you should go with the wired headphones or the wired earphones. So that's all you need to know before buying earphones. So thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe to my channel.